Last week on Give Me a Break.
I want that trip to New York. I'm going to solve it. The answer is give me liberty or give me death.
We did
That's it. Congratulations, Addie Wilson.
If you're determined to do this, do one thing, will you? Use the buddy system. Never get separated. Always stay together, day or night, if you don't want to be found lying in the gutter with your head bashed in. And have a nice trip.
I don't believe it. We only been in New York 2 minutes and already somebody swiped my bag. I see who did it. It's that crook over there. Look, he's not gonna get away with this.
Got another one?
You all right, lady?
Sure. I'm a Pisces.
Suppose you want another light?
Please. Thank you. Have a nice day.
You ought to know this is the greatest, most thrilling city in the whole world. Uptown and downtown, east side, west side, all around the town. And at the end of the trip, don't forget to have a hot pastrami on rye.
Mm. You know, the way you talk about New York, you sound like the mayor.
Some people even say I look like him.
A gun?
Yeah.
White powder? Now, I don't think this is your bag. That's the bag I took from the man at the airport. Hello, Nell Hopper speaking. Hello? Hello? Hey, Addie. You know that man that you said would never find out which hotel we're at?
Yeah.
I think he knows which hotel we're in. Maybe the man that owns this won't come looking for us.
Yes, he will. They always come looking for you. You know, this looks exactly like that stuff they kill you for on Hill Street Blues.
I'm gonna call the police.
The dialing instructions are on that little tray. Right?
Bell Captain 64, car runner 33, Pleasure Palace 44, Barbershop 25, Yep Club 27.
Give me this. Come on.
Right here. Take it.
It says right here, for an outside line, dial 90. Now, information is 411, so that's 90411. It's very simple. Okay. Hello. No, thank you. We don't want any theater tickets.
It's very simple. Give me a minute. I'm going downstairs to the payphone.
What for?
Oh, never mind. I'm dripping myself.
It looks like the same man.
And when it comes to killers, close is good enough.
Well, don't worry. I figured out how to use the telephone.
Yeah, what do you do?
Dial O for operator.
Well, get out of the way! Hello, operator. I want to make a long-distance telephone call. This is room 604.
Hello?
Hello, Chief. It's Nell.
Nell, I'm glad you called. I've been feeling guilty about telling you and Addie such terrible stories about New York. New York is as safe as Glenlawn, so forget what I told you.
They're trying to kill us.
What did I tell you?
Chief, look, this is what happened. See, we accidentally picked up the wrong luggage at the airport. This luggage has some drugs in it. And, oh, it has a 45 gun and some size 36 boxer shorts.
Did you call the police?
No, I can't. The man who owns his bag is in the hallway.
Calm down, Nell. Calm down. I'll call my friend with the New York police, Sergeant Madigan. Now, you don't leave your room.
Don't you leave the room.
Do the police arrive or I arrive?
Do they arrive or they arrive?
I'm going to catch the first plane of New York. I'll be there in a few hours.
Oh, thank you, Chief. But, you know, this is all Addie's fault. My fault? Ooh. Look, Chief, the man is big. I mean, he is ugly mean.
Hello, Chief. This is Addie. It was Nell who told her name to the first man who called.
Oh, wait a minute. I was just being polite.
Why are you being polite in New York? You were downright rude in California.
I'm on my way. Don't panic.
Listen, Addie. We would be about to die if you hadn't said, give me liberty or give me death.
Well, I said it, but I didn't mean it.
And another thing. He probably wouldn't have followed us if you hadn't looked so phony puffing on that cigarette.
Don't you blame me. It was your dumb plan.
Don't you dare hang up on me.
I'll hang up on you if I want to.
Oh, yeah? Well, you just take this.
Nell, we gotta pull ourselves together. I'll turn on the TV.
I'm so scared, I don't even know what I'm saying.
Good news, New Yorkers. Now, this cold front, as you can see, is moving out, and a warming trend is moving up from the Gulf right here.
Just my luck to die when there's a change in the weather.
I don't want to watch the weather. It's too depressing. I got a headache and I can't line up the damn arrows on this aspirin box.
Where are the police? I called the chief over 3 hours ago.
And we've called them 3 times since then.
What's that? How do I hear voices?
Look, Madigan, I don't want the New York City Police Department to mess this up. It took me 12 hours to track these two down. Now, the way I figure it, they're a couple of mules. They just deliver the stuff.
Far be it for me to tell a federal officer how to do a drug bust. But those two ladies are friends of a police chief in California.
You're kidding.
It's too bad they stole your bag. Did they get your gun, too?
As a matter of fact, they did. If I saw them take the bag, so did the pusher who wants it. He'll be coming here after them.
Right. Okay, I'll post a couple of my men downstairs.
I'll protect the ladies. Now, you go downstairs and keep your eye out for the fish.
Gotcha.
I think whoever it was left.
Well, did you hear anything they said?
No, they were mumbling something about mules.
People in a New York hotel standing in the hallway talking about mules.
Well, Addie, they could be having a convention of mule salesmen.
You donkey.
Listen, Addie, I can't keep the doors. I'll get there. It might be the police. Hello? Oh, Chief. Oh, Chief. It's the Chief.
Now, my plane had a mechanical. I'm in Salt Lake City. But hang in there. My plane leaves in 5 minutes.
Will you please hurry up, Chief?
Now, what are we gonna do?
Hey, We can get rid of the bag so when the man who owns it comes, we can just... We won't know nothing about it.
And if he can't find it here, he'll leave us alone. That's it. Yeah. Come on, let's just leave this down on the street.
Okay.
The coast is clear.
Get down. Put your coat on. Here. Damn, wait, Eddie. Suppose he's waiting for us in the lobby.
We'll use the emergency stairs.
Good. That's good. Hurry up, let's go, okay? Okay, it's all clear. You with me?
Yeah, I'm with you.
Okay, go.
The emergency exit is over here.
Okay. It's good.
So far, it's working perfectly.
What? All except for one thing.
What?
We forgot the bag.
What?
That'd be cool. Just, hey, just don't attract attention, okay?
Okay.
Nobody's watching. Let's leave it here.
There's a cab, let's grab it. Go.
Excuse me.
No.
We saw it first. Cab.
I telephoned for it. All right, ladies. You take my cab.
Addie.
Felix.
Sydney.
Tony.
Randall.
All that and more.
What are you doing here in New York?
I am New York.
Big star, giving us his cab.
I would give you my cab even if I were only a little star.
Mr. Randall, hello. I'm Nell Hopper. I won a trip to New York, and I brought along my friend.
Mr. Randall. What? Mr. Randall, we couldn't take your cab.
No, I insist. I'd like to clear up a misconception about us New Yorkers. We are not rude, aggressive, pushy people. We are kind, civilized, gracious people. Hey, animal, where do you think you're going? This cab is the ladies, or I'll bust your face. Don't let the jacket fool you. He's from New Jersey. Ladies, your carriage awaits.
Thank you.
Oh, maybe. Wait till they hear about this and claim I touched you. Beaumont Hotel.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Nice going, Tony. Now where the hell are you gonna get a cab?
Oh, thank heavens. Now nobody can connect us with that bag.
Oh, Eddie, I haven't felt so relaxed since we've been in New York City.
Oh, I know what you mean. Oh, this feels so good.
It's him.
Who cares? Let him search the room. We don't have his bag. Right.
Mr. Tony Randall said you left this on the sidewalk.
Nervous and tense, but ooh, it makes it feel good.
You know, they put up a statue to Thomas Edison for his electric light. But what do they do for the man who invented magic fingers?
Why don't we put up a finger to him?
A finger?
Oh. The lights went out. The lights went on again.
One of us should take a look.
Well, you go. I'm not the curious type.
Nell!
You make me sick! Look, I peep through the peephole. Oh. There's nobody there. Take another peep. Well, I'm peeping. Told you ain't nobody out there.
They must have left. I'll look.
Do that. You're right, there's nobody here.
You want more towels?
Thank you.
Excuse me, the lights just went on and off. What's wrong?
The generator. Happens like that all the time in these cheap hotels.
Do you think we can trust her?
Don't answer it.
I'll get there. Might be the police.
Well, whoever it is, don't give them your name this time.
Right. Hello, this is Addie Wilson speaking.
Look, now, we're grounded in Milwaukee for bad weather. It's freezing. The police haven't arrived yet. Well, sit tight and don't leave the room. My plane for New York is leaving in 5 minutes.
The Chief's in Milwaukee now.
It's a hell of a time to stop for a beer.
I can't stand it! It's driving me crazy!
Honey, you heard her. It's a generator. They'll come back on. Please, just lie down and try to relax. Just lie back.
Okay. Oh, Addie! Who would have thought that you and I would end up in New York City in a hotel room, lying across a bed, waiting to be murdered? Oh, help. What was that?
The lights went back on.
Okay. All right. The lights went off. They went on. They went off. They went on. They went off and on. I can't stand it. I tell you, if I live through this, I'm going to kill that Thomas Edison.
I'll answer it. Hello, Nell Harper here.
Oh, hi, Chief.
I'm in Albany. My plane leaves in 5 minutes.
Okay, Chief, I'll tell her. Bye. The Chief's in Albany.
Well, at least he's closing in on it.
Don't answer the door.
But God, it might be the police. I got this. Oh, you going with me? Come on.
No.
Oh, yes. Get over here. Oh, it's him. He's after us.
The gun.
The what?
The gun.
I ain't shooting no gun at nobody.
We'll fire it out the window. That way it'll attract the police. In fact, there's some police down there right now.
I can't pick up no gun. I'll pick up the gun. No, the chief said never pick up a gun. It's dangerous. I'll pick up the gun.
Wait a minute. Wait. I was wrong. You can't fire a gun out the window. You're liable to hurt somebody.
What?
Fire it into the pillow. They'll hear the gunshots in the street.
Oh, okay.
You did it.
I shot. Now that's them shooting each other down the street. Addie. I think we're dealing with a professional here.
Run.
No.
Oh,
with security right here.
Should have thought of that before. They're right here in the hotel. They'll be here in 2 seconds.
Hello, security. This is room 60. They put me on hold. They're playing music.
We're gonna die, Nell.
Y'all get my handsome but boy for me, but need my control. Oh, it's a nice arrangement.
What was that?
It's a good thing this hotel has chains for extra protection. This hotel has a lot to learn about extra protection. Eddie! Nobody pays any attention to a victim's nails.
I always do my nails when I'm nervous.
Close it, okay? Close it.
Nell.
Hmm?
Supposing he has to go to the bathroom.
If he doesn't, do. In the shower, in the shower. In the shower. Shh. This is a perfect hiding place.
It worked like a charm in Psycho.
Here, okay.
Hey, you two in there?
Remember, the buddy system. Don't kill us.
We have connections.
Yeah, we know Mayor Cox.
And we're Tony Randall's best friends.
In fact, he's the one that brought the bag up here.
But, yeah, don't kill us. Kill Tony Randall.
Kill Tony Randall.
We won't tell the police.
I am the police.
You mean you scared us half to death, and you didn't tell us you were a cop?
I'm an undercover cop. I was gonna make a bust at the airport when you two ladies messed things up by taking my bag.
And you couldn't say one word to us?
I figured the guys I was after would show up here after you, and I would nab them.
Oh, so you were using us as bait.
It worked. Well, the cops got them downstairs. Didn't you two hear the gunshots? Oh, I get it. Of course I was worried about you two. That's why I broke in the room.
This is hilarious. You mean you set us up and didn't tell us? I could die laughing.
You know what the funniest thing is?
What?
When I saw you two at the airport, I thought you were a couple of mules.
Mules!
What did you kick me for?
What did you expect from a couple of mules? A kiss?
Here, go. Come on, honey, let's go find us some hot pastrami.
Here, get my clothes out of this place.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm glad we're leaving.
Me too, child. I've had enough of excitement.
You better hurry, ladies. Your flight for Los Angeles is boarding at gate 32.
Thank you. Let's go.
I'm safe.
Home, sweet home.
You know, I still can't believe we got ourselves so involved. This would never have happened if we hadn't been so paranoid.
Well, next time we go to New York, we know better, won't we?
You know what? I bet the Big Apple is just as safe as little old Glenlawn.
All right, ladies, don't scream. Nobody gets hurt.